Hello friends, in this video we will learn regarding the pressure measurement. Now we all are aware with the word pressure. Pressure is a kind of force applied on a particular area. Now we can see here, pressure is an analysis of an applied force by a fluid or a gas on a surface. Pressure is typically measured in the unit of force per unit of surface area. Either it is measured in Newton per mm square or Newton per meter square also. Now there are several instruments which are used to measure the pressure. We are normally aware with the word pressure gauge. So pressure gauge is a kind of gauge which shows the pressure which is being measured. Burden tube type pressure gauge is a simple pressure gauge which is used to measure the pressure nowadays. But other than this, some special even YouTube manometers are also nowadays very much commonly used to measure the pressure. Some special instruments are used to measure the pressure. In this video we will see regarding the special instruments which are used to measure the pressure. As you can see, a pitot tube. Basically, a pitot tube is used in the wind tunnel experiments and on airplanes to measure the flow speed. It's a slender tube that has two holes on it. The side hole measures the static pressure. By measuring the difference between these pressures, you get the dynamic pressure, which can be calculated. Which calculates the airspeed. So you can see here in this diagram, I'll show you. This is the pitot tube, and this is the, we can say, the main kind of wind tunnel where the air is blowing with velocity v. So here there are two tapping. One is at the surface of the wind tunnel and another is at the center of the wind tunnel. So the difference between these two, as we know, the velocity is maximum at the center. We get the pressure difference here. So by measuring these two difference, this is what the static pressure which is generated, the stagnation pressure and the static pressure. So the difference which is created over here shows the dynamic pressure which is generated, and it is very simple, and construction is very simple of this kind of pitot tube pressure gauge. The working of this pitot tube is very simple, as shown. The construction, if you see, it's very simple. Now what are the advantage and disadvantage of this pitot tube? Pitot tube measures pressure level in a fluid. They do not contain any moving part and routine use does not easily damage them. So the pitot tube are small and can be used in tight space that other devices cannot fit it out or fit into it. So if you see the construction, it's very simple, and based on that construction there is no moving part in that. So less wear and tear, less damage. So this is the one of the advantage of this pitot tube. The major disadvantage: when a foreign particle is traveling through the wind tunnel, it clogs the pitot tube and disturbs the normal reading, and as a result, this is a major problem that already has been observed in the aircraft, which results into the crash and many more emergency landing. So if there is any foreign particle which is entering the center hole of the pitot tube, it will result into the clogging of that, and the reading or the error is generated in the reading, and which results to some emergency landing or any indirect controls of the flights. The second unit normally which is used to measure the pressure is a pressure transducer. It is a kind of knob, as you can see here in the diagram, and this is the how the pressure transducer is connected. So here a pressure source is there, a C clamp is shown, that when if we compress this bottle, whatever the pressure is generated at this knob, it will be calculated analogically or displayed. So you can see the pressure transducer is a measuring device which converts the applied pressure into the electrical signal. This type of pressure gauge converts the electrical signals or the applied pressure into an electrical signal and further as an analog signal. Generally, pressure transducer consists of two parts: an elastic material which deforms under the application of pressure, and an electric part which detects this deformation. So this portion which you can see here, it is an elastic material. This is here, you can see in this portion. So when with the help of this device the bottle is compressed, so whatever the gas or pressure is there, it is because of this compression the pressure will be developed, and the pressure is created on this elastic material on this pressure transducer. This pressure transducer will send some electrical signals, and here we'll get an display, we'll get some value of the pressure. So here you can see the working of the pressure transducer. A transducer receives sequence of high voltage electrical pulse called the transmit pulse from the echo sounder. When the wave of the sound bounce back, the transducers act as a microphone. It receives the sound wave during the time between each transmit pulse and convert back into the electrical energy. So this is how a pressure transducer is one of the device which is used to measure the pressure. The next pressure gauge is a Bridgman pressure gauge. This is operated on the electrical principle, the resistance principle. When a uniform force is acting on a wire from all the sides and the electrical resistance is changed, and based on that this pressure gauge instrument is used. So when a wire is subjected to pressure from all sides, its electrical resistance change, we all know that. This principle can be utilized to obtain a primary type resistive pressure sensor, and it is called a Bridgman pressure sensor. So in this diagram you can see a Bridgman gauge is there, a bone ring is there, and a wire is wound on this. So when a pressure is acting on this ring from all the side, the resistance difference is generated, and this resistance generated is used to measure the pressure. Here you can see a carbon disc is there. This carbon disc is connected to the resistor, and this resistor generates the difference between the resistance between these two points will create a pressure. So whatever the pressure is developed here will lift this arm, and whatever the pressure generation which is generated between these two, or the resistance, will be compared, and the difference will result to calculate the pressure which is generated by this bellows. These are the bellows. So whenever the pressure is acting on this, this lever will lift up. So these are the two carbon disc stack. So whatever the resistance is there between these two point will change, and with respect to that we'll be able to measure the pressure. So this is a carbon resistance type pressure gauge, and this is a Bridgman gauge again the principle based on the resistive or the change in the resistance. So as I said, the distortion produced in the crystal lattice due to the external pressure caused the change in the resistance. In most of the common metal wires, the resistance decreases with increase in the pressure, while for antimony, bismuth, lithium and magnesium. So that's why here the magnesium is used there as a crystal lattice body. It increases. In cesium, it initially decreases for small value of pressure changes and reaches a minimum, beyond which it increases with increase in the pressure. So friends, in Bridgman pressure gauge, magnesium is used, as we have seen in the diagram, because change in the pressure will result to the increase in the resistance of the wire or the metal. Now the gauge must be used at a constant temperature. This is one of the condition which we have to take into consideration, and has a range from 0 to 1000 megapascal. So here you can see magnesium is used as a metal wire here, which is cored around this. So these are the two different Bridgman type gauge which work on the principle of the pressure of the resistance. Thank you.